Park for round 12 of the Motorcycle News British Superbike Championship. Now I'm joined by Steve Parrish at the hairpin here at Mallory Park. Doesn't get an awful lot slower than this, Steve.
Unbelievable. First gear, 40 miles an hour. Really, there's a lot of action goes on here, and of course a lot of races are won and lost here.
Okay, before we talk about the championship, let's talk about the last round at Alton. What a great weekend for Rob Mack and his team.
It was terrific for Yamaha especially. They've been the stalwarts of the series for a long, long time. And for them to go out there and win after a four-year drought of winning races, it was terrific. And especially for Steve Plater. His smile inside the helmet, so wonder it didn't break the helmet off.
Okay, but we're at Mallory here, business in hand. Steve Hislop, 56 points clear of his nearest rival. A double win here will secure the championship today.
Yeah, it will secure it, but it's going to be tough, it's going to be hard. Now, Hislop, we know, will be looking at Sean Emmett second in the championship, keeping an eye on Michael Rutter. Whether he can win here today, I'm not too sure, but as you say, if he leaves here with more than 50 points, that's his championship.
And Michael Rutter right on Sean Emmett. We didn't think this would happen a few months back, did we?
No, I don't think we did. The Renegade team's got stronger and stronger as the season's gone on. Rutter is absolutely bang on form, so he could be a cat amongst the pigeons here today.
And one name that's not at the races at all, John Reynolds, current champion.
Yeah, now John's had a tough year. The bike's been developed all the way through. Crescent have done a good job, but he's a fighter, John Reynolds. And really, we can still see him have a win this year, but yeah, his number one plate's gone.
We'll see him next year, will we?
Yeah, on the same bike. He's signed and sealed. Done deal.
Steve, you've got the flying lap, I believe.
And I'm looking forward to it.
Off you go.
And this is on board the R1 Yamaha with Steve Plater over the start and finish line. This is the fastest part of the circuit, 155 miles an hour, down one gear into fifth. And as you come into Gerrard's, it's quite bumpy going in, and you start tapping the power on, squeezing the power on this long, long right-hander, and it gets faster and faster, exiting the corner, up into sixth gear one more time, second fastest part of the circuit, but then down two gears, into fourth for Lake S's. As you come out of this corner, it's hard on the power, up the hill, holding fourth gear, nearly on the rev limiter, right the way down into the hairpin. First gear, using the slipper clutch all the way down into this slow, slow corner. Out of here, first, quickly into second. Second, up to the bus stop now, flick it left and right, and coming out of here, it's second and third, straight away into fourth gear, running down this hill as you come down, it's negative camber, and it's very, very hard, over the line again.
With four races left in which to wrap up the title, Steve Hislop was determined to start Mallory from pole position. He blitzed the lap record in the Dunlop-sponsored Super Pole, and looked like he'd done enough with a fantastic time. Then along came Michael Rutter. Rutter was looking very quick all day through qualifying here, and his Super Pole lap was no exception. The quickest ever time round Mallory Park. Rutter claimed pole. Just look at the time in the bottom of your picture. Steve Hislop could not believe that. And there is confirmation of Rutter's time, over a second inside the lap record. Hislop then in second, seventh and eighth, Carl Harris and Dean Ellison. They crashed earlier in the proceedings, so they've done well. A bad qualifying for Steve Plater, ninth, and in 14th, 343, Jason Davis, a serving fireman, carrying that number out of respect for the New York Fire Service victims.
Okay, front row of the grid, John Reynolds in fourth place, the current champion, alongside him, Shane Byrne. And in second place, Steve Hislop. Steve, and we all know a double win here today will make him the champion. Steve, I know you're going to tell me you're taking every race at a time, but it must be in the forefront of your mind.
Yeah, but I mean, at the end of the day, if you mess around and get tangled up in the park, that could be all over. So I've just got to go and try and race like I usually do, you know.
But you might say that. Well, the pressure is certainly on, and Michael Rutter alongside him in pole position put in a storming lap yesterday. Actually took a second off the current lap time. If I can just pop around and have a quick word. Michael, incredible time yesterday.
Yeah, everything went well in Super Pole. Just got to win the race now.
Not taking the heat off the man to your right anyway.
Oh, well, just got to try and get out in front and make myself wide as hell. It's a long way, 30 laps around here, and we'll see what happens.
Okay, thanks, Michael. Time for the racing. Let's go to the commentary team of Steve Parrish and Barry Nutley.
Well, 30 laps of Mallory Park equals 41.1 miles of this exceptionally tight Leicestershire circuit. 26 starters across seven rows, everybody very focused. A lift in the air from Shane Byrne as he dropped the clutch. A cracking start by number one on the Rizla Suzuki, John Reynolds, but eclipsed by Rutter, and round the outside goes Steve Hislop from second place on the grid, but he's in third. Reynolds noses the big Suzuki. A good start for him. Up into second place on the exit from Gerrards. Number six, Rutter leads. In second place, one, it's Reynolds. Hislop got a good start. That's what he needs to do. Reynolds' teammate, Carl Harris, number 11 there, fighting in fourth place, and it's a determined challenge from Shane Byrne that he's fending off. And up the inside into fourth place goes Shane Byrne. Carl Harris now being followed by a brace of Yamahas. Sean Emmett and Steve Plater riding shotgun for him as they flick it through to complete lap one here at Mallory Park. The sun's out, racing conditions good. Records, sure, Steve, to tumble.
Well, almost certainly, Barry, but look at that man, Rutter. He was the man that set that stunning time. He looks like he's going away as they come round this long, long Gerrards corner. Unbelievable how hard it is to tap the power and just get your exit speed perfectly right as they come out of it. It's very, very bumpy now. Down the fast, stebby straight, and now we're on board with Steve Plater. That's Sean Emmett on the inside as he goes underneath Carl Harris into the S's. That's a good move there from Sean Emmett, getting the drive now back up the hill. Plater is on the outside of Carl Harris. Can he go the long way at the hairpin? I doubt it, but he has. Look at that, he's right on the back wheel of Sean Emmett. Look behind, there they come round the corner. He's got his way past Carl Harris, number 11. Good move there by Sean Emmett and Steve Plater.
Well, Plater was right on the back wheel of Emmett, but they're being dropped away by the leading quartet. Number six, Rutter leads, then it's Reynolds, then it's Shane Byrne. So Renegade Ducati is in first and third. The Monster Mod Ducati of Steve Hislop, the championship leader by 56 points. The yellow flag being waved round the back of the circuit, but the race going on here. By 56 points, Steve Hislop leads the championship. In second place in the championship is Sean Emmett, but Rutter in third in the title is determined to get out in front. But they're all wide sweep through there by Hislop. That cost him valuable time. And if he doesn't watch out, but oh, Shane Byrne now on the inside of John Reynolds at the hairpin. So the Renegade Ducati boys, one and two. Reynolds has got no answer for that. I was about to say, if Hislop doesn't watch out, he's going to fall into the clutches of Sean Emmett and Steve Plater, who are catching fast.
And now we are on board with Plater one more time. Down Devil's Elbow, that's Sean Emmett in front, as you can see, down the fastest part of the circuit. You're right about Hislop. That was a massive mistake. He lost the front going into the S's, ran wide. That's Emmett going a little bit wide, but he manages to claw it back. Holding a tighter line, coming back in at the exit of this corner. It's such an important corner, getting the drive out of there. Look at number three in the background. He gets on the inside there of Hislop, and he's going through Sean Emmett down into the S's. No, this time he doesn't make it. Sparks flying there from Michael Rutter, number six, leading.
Well, a scrap of these Ducati boys at the front, but this battle now, number three, Sean Emmett on the inside of Steve Hislop, and Emmett nursing that hand injury from that painful Alton crash. Plater going with him, Hislop going wide, letting the two Virgin Mobile Yamahas go through there in tight formation. I was about to say that Emmett with a left thumb brake, a rear brake on the left thumb, and a huge pad at the petrol tank to take the load under braking. Plater going through inside Hislop, following Emmett. Emmett cuts back. This is close stuff.
Well, what is Steve Hislop doing? He was so slow into the hairpin there. He allowed both guys to go through. He said he didn't want to get skittled at the hairpin, but boy, he was wide and slow on that corner.
Up to the lead, number eight, Shane Byrne then. Byrne has had three wins already. Is this going to be win number four? He heads Michael Rutter, the blisteringly fast pole position man. Reynolds has regained his composure. Still there in third. He hasn't given up the fight. These three breaking away, but in fourth place, it's Sean Emmett. Steve Plater flicking it through with him. There's Rutter, number six, round the Devil's Elbow. Adverse camber, getting the power on. Shaky Byrne out of the seat. It's so easy, Steve.
Well, it's so easy to get out of the seat because the rear tyre starts spinning out, coming down that negative camber corner, and then it sets the bike wobbling all the way down the fast straight. Look at number 75 there, Glenn Richards. He's closing in on Steve Hislop on the 750 Kawasaki, coming round Gerrards now. The bike might not have quite the speed of the big thousands, but it's got the agility around the corners, and Richards is riding it so well. John Reynolds goes down the inside. John Reynolds up into second place, passing Michael Rutter. This is a battle royal at the front.
It's a battle all the way down the field, and Glenn Richards in seventh place there, qualified sixth, 47.4, so he's quick. Rutter not taking this line down at all. Number six, Michael Rutter in third place, but John Reynolds passing him has allowed the race leader Shane Byrne to ease away, and ease away he is. The two Yamaha boys, three and four, Emmett and Plater respectively locked in a battle, as indeed is Steve Hislop, who is seeing his championship lead being whittled away here, lap by lap by lap, and this is not what the champion leader wanted to see. He wanted to get out there in front, and I'm afraid he's just not doing it. We now have a 10-wheeler. Byrne, Reynolds, Rutter, Emmett, and this is sixth place for Steve Hislop. Number two, way down in sixth. Glenrutter is going to have him in a minute.
Yeah, I think he probably is. This is into the hairpin. Now look at those bikes chattering the way as they go into the corner. All the weight on the front. That's Emmett and Plater charging through there now. They nearly hit each other, really. Number four, Steve Plater and Sean Emmett nearly collided at that point. There's certainly no team orders in the Mobile AWAR team.
Well, number three, Sean Emmett, is in a 16-point position, third place at the moment. And this, an overtaking move, looking forward from Plater, right on the back of Reynolds. You'll see Sean Emmett come into view in a minute, chopping back just across the front. Oh, it is so close. And they are teammates swapping paint. The colour's the same, doesn't matter that much. They're both red bikes. And look at Emmett right now on the back wheel. He's looking at that 20 points. John Reynolds might as well have 20 written on his back, because that is what it's worth if Emmett passes.
Now look at this, Sean Emmett down the inside again, and he forces his way in there, shoving John Reynolds out very, very wide there. And again, number four, Steve Plater and Sean Emmett nearly collide with the Virgin team. And poor old Rob McElhay will be having kittens in the pit lane watching what's going on as they charge down through the corner again. Glenn Richards has got past number two, Steve Hislop, but nearly threw it away as he came through Devil's Elbow.
Well, it's all working for Sean Emmett, because not only has he moved up into a 20-point position, but Hislop has gone even further back down the field. So that 56-point cushion is now very much smaller, and Emmett must sense that there's a race win on the cards here. He certainly will go for it. Michael Rutter has just lost out to John Reynolds, who's fighting back with a vengeance. Rutter then going backwards down the order. So the pole position man, the early race leader, is struggling just a little bit here. The battle at the front has never been more frenetic. Plater nibbling away at the back end of its teammate, Sean Emmett. And I don't know whether there are team orders or not, but they're too mighty close for me.
Well, it certainly doesn't look like it, Barry. Again, they charge onto the fastest part of the circuit. Listen to that big four-cylinder machine screaming down it. And it's so hard with all that horsepower coming out the slow corners. Glenn Richards still doing a good job there. Look at poor old Steve Hislop there. Number two, the championship leader, is just dropping backwards and backwards. There is something wrong with that bike, I'm sure. Or if it's not the bike, there's something wrong with him today.
Look at Shane Byrne. Sean Emmett taking a look at the inside, seeing if there's a way through there to grab the lead here at the Lake S's. Round the left-hander, they go up towards Shores, and this is where Emmett is. Oh, so good. Look at that remarkable move. How precocious is that? Up the inside, and Plater's gone with him. Elbows and wrists, Shaky Byrne and Steve Plater, but Shane Byrne is not a man to be messed with. How close does it get?
Well, again, Sean Emmett, a great block pass down the inside, just puts that R1 Yamaha exactly where Shane Byrne wanted to be. Steve Plater doing everything he possibly could to get through, but not quite, because Shane Byrne just slams that Renegade Ducati down in front of him. There's yellow pass, John Reynolds. That is John Reynolds. That's a massive accident there. Bits of pieces of that Suzuki flying everywhere. Luckily, John Reynolds is getting up and walking away. That was a huge crash.
Well, he's had three now this year, been off it. That is so unlike the reigning champion, but that just underlines how hard he's riding. He has been going so, so hard on that big Suzuki, pushed it to and beyond the limit. But look at this! Plater up to second! It's a Virgin Mobile Yamaha 1-2 here at Mallory Park. Plater is off the back of a win at Alton, and he senses there might be another one on the cards here. Head down for Steve Plater, but it's his teammate Sean Emmett. Steve.
He's just getting such good drive out of the hairpin. That's number four, Steve Plater. Nipped up the inside. Now, normally the Ducatis, we say they have a lot of bottom-end power, but I think maybe they have too much out of that really slow corner. The Yamaha has much smoother power delivery, and he is excellent out of that corner. Number four, Steve Plater. So that's the battle, as you say, Virgin Yamaha 1-2 here behind Shane Byrne. Rutter having a bit of a comeback now in fourth spot.
Well, this season has been very much about the unfolding rule changes, and now we're seeing the four-cylinder bikes as Emmett grabbing the lead. Rutter up to third. Emmett now still leading from Plater. Plater fighting back, looking at the inside line on the Devil's Elbow. Nearly side by side as they exit, but line astern, away they go down the straight. As I was about to say, and I'm going to finish it, we've seen the four-cylinder bikes get quicker and quicker and quicker, and we are now seeing a true race. It's four-cylinder versus the famous all-conquering Ducatis about to be beaten.
This is just a fair and square battle, as you say. There's no reliability problems here whatsoever. They're all all in this race. Number three, Sean Emmett leads from his teammate Steve Plater. There is number six, Michael Rutter and Shane Byrne. As you rightly say, the four-cylinder bikes just seem to have the edge at certain places. But number four, Steve Plater, is so fast. Look at him take a tight line out of there. He just gets a driver. This time he's gone through. Number four, Steve Plater takes the lead.
And that scrap at the front has allowed, while Steve Hislop tours around still in sixth place, so he's on for 10 points. I was about to say, it's allowed number 75 on the 750cc Kawasaki, Glenn Richards, to close right on the back of Shane Byrne. He has had the ride of his life, the Australian, on the green meanie. The Hawk Kawasaki just has been stunning all season, and Glenn Richards on fifth place here senses that a fourth is on the cards if only he can muscle it past Shane Byrne. But that will not be easy.
No, it certainly won't. Just half a lap to go, and look how hard Plater's going there. He's not slowing down and letting Emmett through, that's for sure. He'd got that R1 sliding as they came out of the S's, as they're going, and Rutter's on the wide line, but I'm sure he won't get through. Just two more corners to go.
Plater then taking a canny route through the bus stop chicane. Emmett in second place, looking a little bit vulnerable now, but I think the Yamaha will get the drive. A twitch from Rutter. Plater gets the win. What a great, great result for the man from Woodall Spa. His antics have to be seen to be believed, but Hislop gets 10 points for sixth place. Not at all happy, but at least he finished. The body language there. Nope, something's wrong with the bike, he said. Nothing wrong with Plater's bike. An unbelievable win. He is a happy boy.
And so he rightly should be off that win at Alton Park last time out. But Rob McElnay from the Virgin Mobile AWOD team will be ecstatic.
And there's the man himself, and he is indeed pleased. Look at Plater, he can always be a stunt rider in his part-time, and confirmation of that win from Emmett. Michael Rutter got third, he recovered. Shane Byrne, Glenn Richards, what a result. Hislop then sixth. Carl Harris with an injured foot in seventh, and John Crawford coming back to form. Crafar, the third Yamaha team member there in ninth. Ellison, Paul Young, Thomas, Adrian Coates, another result for him in 15th. That's the title then. It's closed up a little bit. Emmett nibbled some points back on Hislop. Hislop had better be on his guard next time out. Rutter still in third.
Well, Michael, you're looking pretty good there. And by lap eight, lap nine, just what happened?
Really, I just should have been more forceful there. They're coming past and, you know, just knocking me wide. And I'd have not one come past, three come past. And I just, everything I just did wrong. And I should have been a bit more forceful and, like, try and push people out of the way. Next race, I'll stick my elbows out and my legs out and start pushing people around.
I take it that was your one and only motivation out there, Steve Hislop, and keeping the gap as tight as he can.
Yeah, exactly that. Once I got ahead of Steve, and then I just wanted to sort of get my way up, leapfrog my way up to the front. And once I got to the front, then I was thinking, yeah, I'm going to, come on, let's win it, you know. And then regardless of whether Steve was behind me or whatever, then I knew I'd take points from him. But as it was, you know, it was Steve Plater that managed to nip past, and I just about kept Michael off with a few of sort of fairly hard tactics, but you know, that's racing. You know, we're not here, we're not ballroom dancing, so you know, you've got to do what it takes to win.
Well, Steve, another win. Clearly very happy, it should be.
Yeah, you know, it's obviously very happy. It felt quite a bit easier in Alton Park. I don't know if it's because I was more relaxed this time. Alton Park was as much relief to get the win as it was as joy, you know, because it was just the season's getting on, and I was sort of beginning to think, is it going to happen? Is it not going to happen? You know, but yeah, happy. Obviously, it's good for the team, good for everybody. We put in a lot of hard work and a lot of laps through practice, so it's paid off.
Well, the beauty of superbike racing is that the crowd can get not only close to the action, they can get very close to the riders, and the odd drink of champagne if they're lucky.
Well, all the talk before race one was whether Hizzy would do the double and take the championship today or not, Paul. Certainly didn't happen there.
Difficult. We seem to have a bit of a tricky tyre, well, so Steve says, but no, he did. He had to struggle from the word go. We struggled for rear grip, but we had that 12 months ago in the first race, ran the same rear tyre in the second one, and it was dead on and won, so that's hopefully that's going to be exactly the same this time. He generally did struggle and is disheartened, but end of the day, Yamaha did us a bit of a favour and no team orders, and Sean finished second, and you know, could have easily, they could have said, you know, pull over and let Sean through. So that was 5 points for us. So yeah, I've got to thank Rob a lot for that, you know. Well, I've got to buy him a pint tonight. That's going to kill me.
Well, Rob, there certainly are no team orders out there, huh?
Not really. I mean, it's such an opportunistic scenario with Sean coming along. But Steve's worked so hard all year. and developing the bike and really putting himself and the team through it. And there's no way I was going to say anything other than go for it, Steve. And I never really, to be honest, never really expected him to be there from third row. It was an amazing race. And I mean, we've seen Izzy. Izzy's maybe, I mean, if I was Izzy, I would definitely be protecting what I've got. And Mallory's, if you're not quite on it, you can get caught out, especially around the bus stop area. So I thought he was just sort of, you could see he had a bit of a problem, and I thought he was being sensible, to be honest, but he's still wide open.
You're questioning the bad tyre. He's questioning the bad tyre. You think Steve might have been backing off a little bit?
No, most definitely not. I think you'll see that in the second race. But, you know, you've got to admire, like, Steve Plater's Rob's rider, and he picked him from the beginning of the year. They've inherited Sean. You know, got to admire him for that. You know, it's great to let his number one man take the spoils. And Steve richly deserves that. He's worked ever so hard all year, and, you know, fair play to him.
You came here clearly knowing what your job was. I mean, a double win would win the championship for you. But that's not going to happen today. Did you really want to bring this to Donington?
No, not at all. We need to get this job boxed off as quick as we can. We don't need to go to Donington because I can't stand any more of this pressure, and neither can the team. But we'll just see how the second race goes. You know, we don't need to win races. If we finish second and Sean's third, we win the championship. So it depends on what happens further down the field. So just got to see what happens, see how it unfolds.
Okay, well, very aggressive racing from Sean there in race one. We'll have that the same in race two?
Absolutely. You know, he knows Mallory. He knows what he has to do at Mallory and what it takes. And if it means swapping a bit of paint, he's up for it. So stand back.
Okay, well, race two is about to begin. This championship is certainly not over yet. Well, you heard what Paul Bird had to say. Himself and Steve Hislop want to wrap this championship up before they go to Donington. You also heard what Rob Mack had to say. Sean Emmett's going to do all he can to make sure it goes all the way to Donington. The fact is, Steve Hislop is 46 points clear of Sean Emmett. As long as he wins today or takes second place and Sean Emmett is behind him, he will leave Mallory Park as the new British champion. That should give you something to think about in the commentary box. Over to Steve Parrish and Barry Nutley.
Well, racing is a very stressful business, not just for the managers, but for the riders, of course. They are extremely focused. 30 laps again here at Mallory Park. A huge crowd looking at this one. And who's going to get the drop into Gerrard's the first time? It's Michael Rutter, number six. You heard by his own admission, he's going to ride tougher and harder this time. He said they pushed him all over the place in race one, and he does not want a repeat performance of that. So can Rutter get his head down and go? Number 75, Glenn Richards. The Kawasaki just let go a little bit on the outside, on the exit of the bend there. There's a rise. They drop over a rise. The rear wheel goes loose. It's very difficult. Cold tyres early on in the race, but Rutter's away. Up into second place, Reynolds. Hislop, a good start this time in third. Shane Byrne further down the order this time because Plater is charging through the field, looking at the back end. You can see, oh, that's Carl Harris. Carl Harris chopping back in front there. There's Reynolds. There's Harris, the other Suzuki number 11 ahead of Plater. Glenn Richards, not such a good start, but Rutter really away with it.
Absolutely. John Reynolds on the Rizla Suzuki there after that crash, back out on his spare bike in second spot. The man that is making up a lot of ground, though, is number three, Sean Emmett. Look at him right behind Hislop. He knows that's the man. That's the yellow helmet in front of him. He has to pass it to keep his championship hopes alive, and he's looking a little bit faster in this second race here at Mallory Park. So as they charge their way through the S's up towards the hairpin, is he going to go past his number two? Hislop going to go down the inside of John Reynolds, and John Reynolds just about locks it up as he shifts down through the gears there, and he's gone through. That's looking back now from Steve Hislop through the bus stop. John Reynolds behind him. That's the number one plate he wants.
Well, we have to give credit to Steve Hislop because the hairpin is not his strong point. In fact, it turned out to be his Achilles heel in the first race, but he definitely made short work of John Reynolds that time. Hislop then in second. Just to paint the picture for you, this race is worth 25 points to the winner. There are two more races to come from Donington Park, so with 75 points up for grabs, number two Steve Hislop has a 46 point championship lead, and Sean Emmett, number three, knows what he has to do. He has to stay with Hislop, if possible get past Hislop and nibble away. And as soon as I speak, Emmett dives up the inside, forcing Steve Hislop wide, almost letting Shane Byrne. So he's moved ahead already, Sean Emmett, up to second place. And Hislop has the pack crawling all over him again. Is he going to keep forcing on, or will he crumble under the pressure?
Well, here we are back at the mad hairpin again, and Hislop had a look over his shoulder. He's just concerned every time he goes into that corner. He said earlier that he thought someone was going to skittle him, knock him down. On board with Steve Plater now. That's Shane Byrne in front of us on the Ducati. Look at how close he is. Now, this will show the speed down the straight, down the stebby straight. The Ducati has the punch out the corner. Plater again late on the brakes, but Plater at the hairpin is dynamic. Just see if he gets through this time around. He gets a drive, he'll switch to the inside. There he goes, down the inside. Look at number four. Steve Plater on the R1. Just dives down the inside of Shane Byrne. Then he has to switch to the inside to keep the tight line. Byrne has another good, forceful look. Can't quite do it. So, number four, Steve Plater up to four.
It's just incredible. They're so close through there. The way they stop at the hairpin, how they get all of that machinery from the high speed down to 40 miles an hour to get around the hairpin, I have no idea. Sean Emmett carrying this huge pad on the back of the fuel tank, which sits in his groin, if you like, really stops him sliding up the bike, helps him under braking, takes the load off his bruised hand, and it really assists him. And surely it's working well here, because Emmett sitting up out of the fairing. Don't forget, Michael Rutter is away in the lead. There is Rutter disappearing from view. This is the battle for second place. Hislop number two is in third. Plater going the long way round and cutting the nose off Steve Hislop and claiming third place. So Steve Plater on a charge again, but Sean Emmett, his teammate, leads him. Shane Byrne, number eight, is behind Hislop, whose championship lead is being whittled down and down and down. It was 46 points coming into this race. It is now decidedly less than that if things stay the way they are. So it's looking already, Steve, as though Donington Park is going to be the finale of all time.
Almost certainly, because Sean Emmett is taking it to the wire. There he is, number three, followed by Plater, his teammate behind. Shane Byrne's already having a look at number two, Steve Hislop. Hislop, really, as you say, his Achilles heel is the hairpin. He seems to be fairly early on the brakes. Can't get that Testa Stratta Ducati to come out the corner that well. Shane Byrne, number eight, goes down the inside and disposes him another place back for Steve Hislop. What is happening to him at Mallory Park here today?
Well, the Kawasaki of Glenn Richards is closing on the back of number one, John Reynolds. So there's a four-cylinder scrap going on behind this quartet. Michael Rutter on the Ducati is out in front. Tail end is already ahead of them, and now Steve Plater challenging again Sean Emmett, but Emmett means business this time, but he's in second place in the race. 20 points is what he will get if he keeps it all together. Keep it on the island. Look at the back wheel of the Virgin Mobile Yamaha, just moving and snaking over the tarmac under power, down the gearbox again into the Lake S's. Tail end is ahead of them. Are they going to be a factor as we come up to the hairpin? Blue flags will be waved to them. That's number 97, Davey Wood. Oh, Davey Wood goes wide. Everybody goes underneath. Emmett has lost out to Plater, who capitalised on that. It's nip and tuck.
It really is, but Steve Plater is stunningly fast out of the hairpin. He just seems to get good drive out of there. That onboard shot showed how hard they were working. There's Paul Bird, Steve Hislop's boss. We heard him say earlier he thought it was a bad tie that Hislop had, but things are still not going at all well for that Monster Mob team. But they're going very well for the Virgin Yamaha team, because look at this. Battle for second place. Remember, Michael Rutter, he's already a long way in front. Emmett desperately trying to get past his teammate now as he forces his way down the inside so late on the brakes into the S's. So he didn't like being passed by Plater there, did he? He knows that he needs those points for this championship.
Well, Sean Emmett, number three, is a true professional. He obviously didn't like being passed by Steve Plater. And if the truth be known, he probably didn't like giving away 5 points to him in race one. But Plater taking a look over his shoulder. Emmett is much more on fire this time, and he knows how large the threat is looming behind him. Shane Byrne as well. Rob McElnay so excited with things going on here. He can't believe what's happening. We are on the last lap, on board two with Steve Plater.
And just look how close we are. Plater is right on the back wheel of Emmett, number three. Emmett will be just trying to squeeze the power as quick as he can down the straight. You watch him switch to the inside. He'll be trying to keep a nice tight line. He will not be wanting to leave a gap anywhere. There's your leader.
Michael Rutter has ridden an immaculate race from start to finish, but this is the all-important battle for second place, because number three, Sean Emmett, is on for 20 points. It's about the championship. He is in second place in the championship. Can he keep it tight through here? Plater making a dive on the inside. Shane Byrne over the line goes Rutter with a triumphant wheelie, but Sean Emmett holds it at the flag for second place and 20 points. Hislop in the back of your picture with the yellow helmet, trailing Shane Byrne home, second, third, fourth, and fifth for Steve Hislop. 11 points. It will keep his championship lead alive, but it is diminished. Michael Rutter, 25 points. His season would have been a totally different story had he not broken down and fallen off a couple of times. But there, Shane Byrne celebrating in true style and confirmation of the result. Rutter, Emmett, Plater, Shane Byrne, Hislop, as I say, fifth. Glenn Richards, another stunning ride for the Kawasaki man. Reynolds, seventh, his teammate behind him. Crawford again, consistent with Crafar. Gary Mason, a good finish for the Honda number 15. Well, Paul Bird's worst fears are realised because it is going to go all the way to Donington Park with a 37-point gap at the top of the table. And, of course, the battle for second and third still very much alive.
You didn't hold off. Clearly no team orders really there, let's be honest.
No, you know, it's one of those things. Just basically, obviously, with his lot going backwards again, it's more okay, so I was just going to help Sean out at the end if he needed it, you know. But I kept trying to look behind at the hairpin. I couldn't see his. It was just shaky, so I was trying to fend him off and have a go at Sean at the same time, just see what happened in the last couple of laps.
I'm well happy. I mean, it's a really good result, and got the Yamaha around really good, so I'm really adapting to it now. And, you know, it's proven that, you know, won the first race, and I've had 2 seconds, so I'm really pleased with the team, and I'm really pleased with the championship that, you know, it's still something to go and watch, you know, it's not all over.
What a great race. You left from the start and you just took it all the way.
Yeah, really, I just pushed hard as I could. I knew I had to. Last race, I messed myself up. I should have gone hard at the beginning, but I knocked about and everything. I just really had to just go there and try and push and win.
Well, that's all from Mallory Park, where the crowd are very, very excited, and so they should be. This is going all the way to Donington. So join us on October the 6th on BBC Two for the final instalment of this wonderful championship. Of his life.